Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika and in this video I'm going to talk about stars in InDesign. And if you have seen my video about stars in Illustrator, you already know what the problem is. But in InDesign it's even worse. So in order to create a star, we're going to look at the tools. So here we have the tools. We have a rectangle tool, which is usually in front. And there are some hidden tools. We've got an ellipse tool and a polygon tool, but there is no star tool. So let's take the polygon tool. And to use it, you can click and drag and get a polygon, or you can just click and enter the dimensions, and then you have some other settings. Other than in Illustrator, you don't enter the radius, and for a star, the inner and the outer radius, but you enter the dimensions of width and height. And then you can also enter the number of sides and a percentage of star, kind of a starness of the polygon. But let's see what the issue with this is. I'm going to cancel it and just delete this one as well. And I'm going to click and drag and press the shift key as the shift key gets us a regular object, which is exact, an exact polygon. So I have created it and let's take a look at the size. And you see this is 55 by 52 millimeters, so it's not a square. It's the size of that bounding box, and this will only be square for certain polygons, like an eight-sided polygon. So before drawing that polygon, you don't know the proportions of its width and height, so you're not able to enter that in the numeric dialog box. Now that we know that, how can we even draw a star? So let's take a look at that as well. I'm going to take the tool again and let's get to the secret. Now usually when you want to change a polygon or rectangle while drawing it, you have to press certain keys. And in order to change the number of sides, well, that could be the arrow keys. But when you press them, this is what happens. So that's not correct. In order to change that, you hit the spacebar once, and then you can use the arrow keys. And in order to make this into a star, you use the left and right ones. So I'm going to press the right arrow key and there is my star. And then I can still use the up and down arrow keys to get the number of points of the stars. And before I leave the mouse button, I'm pressing the shift key in order to make this exact, like so. Now I can let the mouse button go and I get the star, the exact star. And again, we see width and height are not equal, so we wouldn't know the size of that star. Now, InDesign offers another ability. You can now double-click the polygon and change the settings. So I could change this to 8. You see, we've got the 8-pointed star. But InDesign didn't change the width and height, so this is of no worth for us because this star would have a square bounding box, and we can change that afterwards, of course, but we wouldn't know for other stars, so we can't use that changing. The only way to get a perfect star in InDesign is to draw it and to use these keys. So that's how you can achieve the perfect geometric shapes in InDesign. Happy creating! If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time!